Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today in this short video, I want to go over how to change your Freedompop service from the premium plan to the free basic plan. And that would mean that instead of having to pay $25 a month, you go down to paying nothing per month. And yes, the phones still work. I've been able to make calls on the one that I've already changed on. And I've actually been using this one since 2015. No problems making calls, receiving calls. It's been working great. Now, what I've done recently is I went over and I saw that Freedompop was having a sale. So I went and I bought a few more. So this one here, this is a moto-e second generation. Just got this one last week for $29. The plan that comes with it is free for the first month, but after that I'd be charged $25 a month. And then there's a service that's free as well for the first month, but after that it's 10. That adds up to $35 a month I'd be paying for if I wanted the premium plans as well as the premium services. Now the services are kind of nice. They are comparable to $120 worth of services from Verizon. So it is an outstanding, wonderful deal if you want to do that. What do you get with it? Well, you get free tethering. Well, they call it free, but you pay $10 as part of this plan. It all adds up to $35 a month. The tethering means that you can use your phone as a hotspot and get connected to the internet through your laptop. So you can browse the internet and all that right through your phone. And so that's called tethering or a hotspot. That's part of the plan. There's other things in there such as data rollover, and you get 2 gigs per month for paying the $25. And then the $10 is all these other little features that come with it. So here's the Motorola E, had it for 1 week and have actually been making calls with it. With this one here, I've had this one for 2 years and making calls with the free service. And I'm going to downgrade this one to the free service because I'm happy with just the free basic service. Now in all, I have 10 of these phones. Here's the other two more that I have. And these are the Huawei phones. I just got these last week as well. And these are $29.99, so $30 basically. And that's it. I didn't have to pay anything else. They come with a free first month premium service. Again, it's the same thing. It's $25 for the premium service plus $10 for these other services. So it comes up to, if you don't do anything at all, just let it slide for a month. After 1 month, you will get a bill for $35 on each of these. But I'll show you again how to downgrade it to the free plan. On the phone, when you do that, you want to go into your settings. Once you're into your settings, go to data and then limit your data to be whatever you've planned that you've gone for. So if you have a 2 gig premium service, set it to limit you at 2 gigs so it doesn't go over the 2 gigs. Basically what happens is when it approaches the 2 gigs, it gives you a warning, and then when it reaches 2 gigs, it just stops. It doesn't receive any more data from the cellular service. And that's great because that means you won't receive any extra charges. So here we have a few of the Freedompop phones. These are the Huawei phones that I received the other day. And then these are the Motorola phones, Motorola E second generation. These were on sale for $29.99 activation, but then the phone itself is free. And that's actually a good deal because the phone itself would be more than just $30. Let's show you now the app called My Freedompop. And to find it, let's go over here to this one. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go find the app. So we click on all apps. And after going into all apps, we look for the app called My Freedom. There it is. There it is right there. So click it. And you'll say log into your Freedompop account. Let's say you have one already, you would put in your email and your password to your Freedompop account and then click on next. Now let's just say that you're brand new to Freedompop, then you have to click on create a new account, which is right here. Just click on
create a new account. Once you clicked on create a new account, it'll come up with your email address at the top and you simply say allow. And this is an automatic account creation for you. And you say allow. Okay, now once you've created that account at freedompop.com, that was easy to do. You just went to the browser and you browsed to freedompop.com, and from there you get a chance to log in or create an account at that time. And I just did that here on this phone. Now you need to go in and actually use your app to log in. So click on all apps and you need to find the app called My Freedom. So there it is, it's My Freedom. And you key in your email address and the password that you've set up with Freedompop. So I'll type in the password now. Once you've keyed in the password, simply click on go and it will log you in. Now from there, it's going to show you your activity on your particular device. So it'll show your usage, how many days you have left in the billing cycle. What we see here is, let's go over to the account. This is the support side. So if you're having difficulty, you'd have the this one here, where this is support. This is the account. And let's just see, it says your plan. So the plan on this phone is $25 a month. And that's the premium with 2 gigs and it's for a particular phone number. You can manage the plan and actually downgrade it to the basic plan if you want to, which is free. If you go down here, you also have One Services, which allows you for the hotspot and other services there, the data rollover and all that. That's for $10, includes all those different services. And then you can see the data overview and other settings you have for the phone. Now if I go over to this phone here, it shows my usage, how many days I have left on the cycle, and then what do I have as far as voice, data, and messaging. And my plan that I have is the free plan. So let me show you how to manage your services here. You go down to your plan and you click on manage plan. And then right here, where it says what plan that you have, click it. And there you have the cancel service. So you click that one and then follow the prompts to cancel that particular service.
Once you clicked on that red text that said cancel the service or plan, it'll open up to a browser window like you see here. I'm doing this on a PC so you can actually see where I'm clicking. You go to my account and plans or services to cancel any of your plans or services. And here I'm in the plan. So I go down here to where it says details and plan management. I click there. And then right here it says to downgrade this plan, click here. So I click there. And then click right here where it says downgrade anyway. Then click OK. Then put in your password. Then click submit. Now you're given one last opportunity to turn around and make a U-turn. They're actually giving you twice the data for the same price per month. For, it says up here, for 6 months. And you click on the green button that says double my data. So if you wanted that, which is actually a very good deal, you click there and you get 4 gigs per month on your phone there for $25. If not, you can click on downgrade anyway. There you have it. It is possible to downgrade your plan to the basic plans. Now, if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and comment down below if you have any questions. Thank you very much and bye-bye.